Hey everybody, Alex Moen here with today's Biz Tech Tips, and today we will evaluate different video conferencing options. So first you want to know, what is the purpose of your video conference? Is it personal? Is it one-on-one? Is any confidential or private information going to be discussed? What does that look like? So first we'll talk about Zoom, because lots of people are using it because it's very usable in a whole bunch of different situations, but there have been lots of security issues lately too. So what you want to do is, if you have the right settings, you can at least improve the security a little bit. Right now, waiting rooms are mandatory. If that ever changes, you still want to utilize them. You want to not allow screen share or file share access, even if you think you know everyone that's going to be on the call. Use a different password each and every time you set up a video conference. Don't allow others to record. Don't allow people to dial in over phone. And ideally have somebody with a paid account that can select a local server to connect to. But to also keep in mind too, 500,000 people, it was just revealed, had their password stolen. So change your password. And if your Zoom password is anything remotely near another password, change that other account as well. So final assessment, it's okay for usability and things like that. Great for usability, actually. But if security is any concern there, you should steer clear. And actually, Microsoft Teams is my biggest recommendation, just in terms of usability, features, and security. Pretty much everything else out there lacks in one of those three areas. Microsoft Teams is pretty good across the board. And they do have a free version, too, that's pretty robust. But the paid versions are a little bit better, a little bit more secure. So it starts at $5 per user per month if you just get Teams, or for Office 365, it starts at $12.50 per user per month, and you get the whole suite of their other stuff there. Aside from that, if you're doing just quick, you know, small groups, that kind of a thing, FaceTime is great if everyone has an iPhone. WhatsApp is great across platforms, and it's true end-to-end encryption. Or Skype, it's not as secure, but lots of people have it. Those are all options I have for you. Let me know what you use. Don't forget to like, and have a good one.